welcome to my channel. Thanks so much for your support. Thanks for being part and subscribing. If you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. Support this channel to grow. Today, I'm here to give you a summary of lesson 6, that is Sabbath afternoon and Sunday. Lesson 6 talks about more lessons from the master teacher. More lessons from the master teacher. And our memory test is taken from Mark 10:52. And I read, then Jesus said to him, go your way, your faith has made you well. And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus on the road. Amen. The introduction of the lesson is drawing our attention to the fact that all of us, when we sin, we feel bad. We feel ashamed. Unless you don't have conscience, your conscience will fight you and you will not be comfortable. It's the same way when Adam and Eve sinned. They felt so bad, they felt ashamed to the extent that they were hiding from God. When Jacob deceived the father and took the blessings of the brother, he couldn't stand it. He ran away. It's the same way when David sinned. It felt so bad. And so when we sin, we are not comfortable unless your conscience is dead. And so the lesson says that, of course, that's one reason the gospel is universal. And Christ's death was for all humanity. Whatever our differences, surely one thing unites us, our general sinfulness. So all of us, we have one thing that we are struggling with, and that is sin. Your sin might be different from mine. Mine might be different from yours. Doesn't mean one is perfect than the other. We are all sinners, and it's just by the righteousness of Jesus Christ that makes us whole. Hence, true Christian education must be about pointing us to the only solution for our rather dismal state. This week, we will look at our only solution, our master teacher. Amen. Our only solution is Jesus Christ, our master teacher. So the whole of this week, we are going to learn more lessons from our master teacher, Jesus Christ. Sunday talks about instead of hiding, and we know the story from Genesis 3. When God instructed Adam and Eve not to eat the fruit of the tree, the forbidden fruit, but they allowed the devil to deceive them, and they ate the fruit. The Sunday lesson is telling us that some people are ascribing that the fruit is apple. The Bible never mentioned apple. It said the fruit of the tree. And it doesn't really matter what kind of fruit it is. All that we know is the Bible says the fruit of the tree. The kind of fruit doesn't matter. Eating from this tree was forbidden because the tree stood for something. It stood for the temptation to push God aside and to declare, I can be the measure of my own life. I can be God to myself. I have authority over the word of God. And so it's not about the kind of tree or the kind of fruit, but the fact that God has said this is forbidden. Don't eat it. And so disobeying is trying to tell God that I don't need you. I can do everything by myself. But the truth is, humanity, there is no way we can do things by ourselves without God. How strange that God would ask Adam, where are you? God certainly knew where he was. Perhaps the Lord asked the question to help Adam and Eve realize just what they were doing, hiding as a result of what they had done. That is, he was helping them see the sad result of their actions. And so when God came and asked Adam, where are you? Adam, where are you? He said, I am naked. Who told you you are naked? And so doesn't mean God didn't know where Adam and Eve, where they were. God knew. There's nothing can be hidden from God. He knew where they were hiding and knew why they were hiding. But he wanted them to realize their state and what they have brought upon themselves. It's the same way God is asking some of us, where are you? Some of us have committed some sort of sins and we are hiding from God. We don't even want to have anything with God again because we feel we have sinned. And so there's no way getting close to God. God is asking us, where are you? Where are you in your Christian faith? Where do you stand? Are you with me or you are with the devil? Where are you, my brother, watching me? In our own ways, we too have done the same thing. And Jesus has come to rescue us. Hence the question, where are you, could be asked of us as well. That is, where are you in your your sin and guilt in relationship to Jesus and what he has done to rescue you from it. Amen. Christ has come to rescue us, just as God took the initiative to go into the garden and search for Adam and Eve and bring them back to himself. It's the same way Christ came to bring us back to him, himself, to die for us so that through him we have salvation. And so the question is, where are you in your state of Christianity? Where are you? Are you in the middle? Are you with God or you are with Satan? Bear in mind, you cannot be in the middle. So Christ is asking you, where are you? Thanks so much for being part of today's summary. Please, if you have not yet subscribed, consider subscribing. Do well to share the video, like, and leave a comment. Bye-bye.